After the world network properties, let's see now the distribution and patterns of networks. We will see four different patterns, but first we will see two of them, some classical patterns and the core periphery pattern. In the 50s began a lot of experiments in the MIT to test the different properties of very simple and classical patterns like star, Y, chain, circle, and showing their properties of centralized or decentralized networks, but they did not develop really measures. Very rapidly, a special attention was given to the core periphery model, which is quite important in geography. Here we have an idealized pattern formed by a core of one click, which is a complete graph, with a periphery of nodes that are linked to the core, but not transversally. So this network can be represented in this matrix here, with in red the core nodes, which are all connected and connected to the nodes of the periphery, but the periphery is not connected all together. This kind of matrix can be used for classification of nodes according to their equivalence, and we can use structural, automorphic, or regular equivalence, and we will see that in the block modeling course 4. But also, we can make some measure of this core periphery property. So the first measure is to calculate the proximity between this ideal network that we just see, and so the perfect pattern, and the observed network. So we multiply the observed network here by the ideal one, which is the pattern matrix. And so we can have a maximal index if the observed matrix is very close to the ideal matrix. And we can use and calculate this kind of proximity also with a quantitative continuous value and correlate to the pattern matrix. Another measure is a measure of a concentration index. So we differentiate the core and periphery node centralities. So the actors are ranked according to their centrality index, C1, C2, and so on. And so this is the rank C1 according to their centrality. And so the first G actors comprise the core. So we have Ci is the centralities of the core actors, Ck is the centralities of the periphery actors, and so the concentration index is the difference between all the centralities of the core and the maximal centrality in the periphery, and we add the difference between the minimal centrality of the core and all the centralities of the periphery. All this is standardized, and so we have a concentration index. More this index is high, and more the centrality is concentrated inside the core, beside the periphery.